How does one measure success? Nasa dami ba ng pera, bilang ng awards, or laki ng office? In a fiercely competitive place like New York City, ibang level na ang labanan, especially for those in high-profile professions such as medicine and law. Happily, our clinicians in New York have taken on the challenge and secured their spots as successful professionals. In fact, ipapakilala sa atin ang isa sa kanila ng ating NY Chica Girl. Kaya Monet, chika mo na.
When New York City's competitive nature strikes, the dream and will to succeed are just about what every New Yorker clings on to so tightly. And as we allow achieving New Yorkers to constantly amaze us, excited akong malaman mula sa ating mga kanation how they consider someone to be a successful professional in this great city.
Definition is so simple. Contentment and morals, and you have dignity, integrity. As a person, that's a success.
Someone who's happy with their job, enjoys going to work every day, and doesn't mind going that extra mile to do stuff for others.
Someone who is loving what they're doing, who is collaborating with other Filipinos, and are making things happen, not just for them, but for the entire Filipino community.
Para masabi ko sa sarili ko na successful ako is mahal ko yung trabaho ko na hindi ako nag-iisip na oras na para umuwi. Hindi ko nare-regret na nandito ako sa ibang bansa na malayo ako sa Pilipinas kasi masaya ako sa trabaho ko.
Everybody wants to be in New York, and if you're here and you're doing what you love, I think that's good enough.
It's really good to know that a successful professional is taken by our nation in a much deeper sense, hindi ba? And today, we got into the professional world of one successful native New Yorker, attorney Rio Guerrero, right here in the heart of Brooklyn.
So what's with Brooklyn?
Well, okay, so Brooklyn has experienced this wonderful renaissance in the last 15 years. It's always been sort of this smaller neighborhood compared to Manhattan. But in the last 15 years, it's got its own identity. Wonderful parks like the one we're in today are being built. The view of the Brooklyn Bridge and also with Manhattan behind you is just inspiring. And
in what way?
In what way? Well, you see the achievements of so many people and you see all of the great work. And it's wonderful that we're so close to probably, I think, the most important city in the world.
His good grip on his Filipino-American heritage helps him navigate the world he is in today.
When I was in law school, I had a wonderful opportunity to receive a fellowship, and I had the opportunity then to travel to Manila, where I served as a legal intern at the Commission of Human Rights and also a non-governmental organization for a summer, and allowed me to connect with Filipinos in a way that I'd never had the opportunity to before, both personally and also professionally.
It's tough to be an entrepreneur, more so here in New York City.
Well, what drove me is that I wanted it to be my law firm. I certainly could have stayed at the law firm that I was at and hopefully eventually become partner there. But I wanted to create something that was mine. The challenge to start the law firm was probably the largest challenge I've faced in my career. And so, not to back down from a challenge, I didn't see that I should be stopped from seeking my goals. Over 10 years later now with the practice, I think we're doing just fine. I'm proud of what we've built. At home, it's really about my wife. Without her, the home wouldn't run. Kids wouldn't be fed and dropped off at school on time, and I wouldn't have the opportunity to take care of everything that I need to at the office if it weren't for her keeping the home running so efficiently all the time.
As the first Filipino-American in private practice to receive the Best Under 40 Award in New York State, Attorney Guerrero's commitment to succeed goes beyond his Lower Manhattan law firm.
My success, I think, is defined by how well we represent our clients, the work that we're doing for them, and then also personal success, sort of a private goal for myself really would be to make sure that I'm giving back to the community that's given me so much. We've had some great successes, but I'm not too different, I think, from other Filipinos, frankly. I mean, I'm here in the United States, second generation Filipino, looking to achieve things with my career and my life, while also honoring my past and passing along, you know, the culture and the heritage that my family has passed on to me, and just trying to, you know, maintain my identity as both as a Filipino and as American.
So there you go, mga ka-nation. Hanggang sa susunod po nating chikahan, don't forget, I'm Monette, ang inyong kadate dito lang sa NYC Chika in the City. We'll be right back.